So with that notion of a concept as functions or as mappings from objects to membership in a set, we have a particular target concept. And the only difference between a target concept and the general notion of concept is that the target concept is the thing we're trying to find. It's the actual answer. Right? So a function that determines whether something is a car or not, or male or not, is the target concept. Now, this is actually important, right? Because we could say that we have this notion in our head of things that are cars or things that are males or things or people who are credit worthy, but unless we actually have it written down somewhere, we don't know whether it's right or wrong. So there is some target concept we're trying to get of all the concepts that might map pictures of people to true and false.
Okay, so if you're trying to teach me what tallness is, so you have this kind of concept in mind of these things are tall and these things are not tall, so you're going to have to somehow convey that to me. So how are you going to teach me?
Ah, so that's exactly that's what comes up with the rest of these things that we're defining here. So let me tell you what the next four things are, and then you can tell me whether that answers your question.
Got it.
How about that? Okay, so we've got a notion of instances, input. We've got a notion of concepts, which take input and maps them to some kind of output. And there's some target concept, some specific function, some particular idea that we're trying to find and we're trying to represent. But out of what? So that's where the hypothesis comes in. In fact, I think it's better to say hypothesis class. So that's the set of all concepts that you're willing to entertain. So it's all the functions I'm willing to think about.
So why wouldn't it just be all possible functions?
It could be all possible functions, and that's a perfectly reasonable hypothesis class. The problem with that is that if it's all possible functions, it may be very, very hard for you to figure out which function is the right one given finite data. So when we actually go over decision trees next, I think it'll be kind of clear why you need to pick a specific hypothesis class to think about.
Okay.
So let's return to that in a little bit, but it's an excellent question. So conceptually, in the back of your head, until we come to specific examples, you can think of hypothesis classes simply being all possible functions in the world. On the other hand, even so far, just with classification learning, we already know that we're restricting ourselves to a subset of all possible functions in the world. Because all possible functions in the world include things like x squared, and that's regression. And we've already said we're not doing regression, we're doing classification. So already, the hypothesis class is all functions we care about, and maybe it's all classification functions. So we've already picked a subset. So we've got all these instances, we've got all these concepts, we want to find a particular concept, and we've got this set of functions that we're willing to look at. So how are we going to determine what the right answer is? So if we try to answer Michael's question, the way that we do that in machine learning is with a sample, or another name for it, which I prefer, is a training set.